It's Professor Dave. Let's talk about decimals.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about place values, so we know about the units place, tens place, hundreds place, and so on, ad infinitum. But what about all the fractions we learned about? Going back to the pizzas, say they are cut into 10 slices. What if we have 1 1/10 pizzas? Is there a way to represent that without having to use an improper fraction or mixed number? There certainly is. All we have to do is extend the place values we know to represent these fractions of one as well. This is achieved with the decimal point. Instead of calling one slice 1/10, we can call it 0.1, since this is the tenths place. Two slices is 0.2, all the way up to 10 slices, which would give us one whole pizza. In this way, if we want to represent a number that is somewhere in between two whole numbers, like the way 1 1/10 pizzas is more than one pizza but less than two, we simply place a dot to the right of the units place and then include as many place values as we need to represent the number. In this case, we just need the tenths place, so 1.1 will suffice, since we have the 1 in the units place and a 1 in the tenths place, indicating that there is 1/10, or one slice, out of the second whole number. The place values to the right of the decimal work just like the regular ones, in that as we go to the left, each place value is 10 times greater than the previous, while as we go to the right, each place value is 10 times smaller. So after the tenths place, we get the hundredths place, thousandths place, and so forth. That means this approach would work even if the pizza were cut up into 100 slices, as each slice, or perhaps more easily visualized, each of these 100 tiny squares, would be 0.01. If the large square were cut up into 1,000 squares, each square would be 0.001, with the 1 in the thousandths place. So we are beginning to see how place values report the magnitude of something. The number 1 is the same symbol no matter how we use it, but it has the capacity to report enormous values, as well as values that represent tiny fractions of 1, all depending on the place value it inhabits. We can do operations with decimal values just as we would normal numbers. We just have to line up the place values. 2.3 plus 1.4 involves adding the tenths together to get 7/10. And adding the units together to get 3 units, so 3.7. This is the same way we would add 23 and 14 together. We just have a decimal place present, which alters the magnitude of the numbers. Later we will learn all about how to convert between fractions and decimals, but for now, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.